Molly's toy corner that I rotate every week, and this week these are the toys I laid out for her. First up, we have her silicone rainbow stacker, and then we also have her object permanence ball drop toy and this really cute wooden bear stacker. I also laid out a basket full of her soft blocks and a really, really simple shape puzzle. When I rotate her toys every week, she can honestly play independently for so long, and it is so amazing. It's really cool to see her look through these toys and explore on her own. Again, I typically rotate her toys every week or so maybe I can start a series here on TikTok. Let me know what you guys think, and I hope you guys found this video helpful.
If you have a toddler at home, then this is your sign to go to Walmart and grab the Kitchen Buddy for only $40. It's really nice because it's counter height and it also has a safety bar to help prevent them from falling. I'll link this in my bio if you're interested.
I have seen tons of comments like this on the video of the fully functioning kitchen that I made for my toddler, and I promise you guys, plenty of messes were made. This video was the first time that he had played with his kitchen, and he was very excited, and he just wanted to play in the water, and he even tried to drink out of the faucet. After that, we gave him a cup to get some water to drink, he dumped it in the sink, we told him no, and then he dumped it all over the floor. And that was totally okay. I 100% expected messes to happen when we gave a one-year-old this kitchen. He has never done anything like this on his own before, so we just explained to him that we're not supposed to dump the water on the floor, and we helped him clean it up. After that, we tried slicing the bananas, and all he wanted to do was eat the bananas. All of this is new to him, and he's learning, and sometimes that can be overwhelming. The reason that we got in this kitchen was for him to learn basic life skills, and in order for him to do that, he's got to make some mistakes, and that's fine. I know cleaning up after a toddler can be so exhausting, but when you teach them something and you see them get better at it over time, it makes cleaning up that mess so rewarding.
Charlie requested,
you know her as poop or whatever.
I wanted to see what my son's semi-Montessori toddler room looked like.
Before I start, I don't think anybody should run their household like a school unless you're homeschooling. So here we have the Montessori floor bed. It's from Sprouts. Absolutely love it. I have a link in my profile if you want a discount code. They're a Utah brand and we love them. Now you can get like a wardrobe for a Montessori room, but we just use this IKEA wardrobe. We made it very toddler friendly by putting everything at his level and his height. He is in charge every morning of laying out and picking out his own clothes. You open up the drawer and we have our shorts, pants, underwear, socks, and his pajamas. The goal here is to set him up for success by organizing everything. He also has a small toy rotation shelf that he uses every morning. He wakes up every morning very early, so I turn on the lights for his room and he's allowed to play and pick what he wants out of these things. They are at his height and easy for him to grab everything. We also leave all of these books out for him so he can pick and read whatever one he wants. Let me know if you have any more questions.
Okay, so here my son is just washing off the fruit. And now he's cutting it up. And trust me, I am fully aware that he is cutting off most of the strawberry, but this is just how he does it, so I'm gonna let him do it his way. But don't worry, all those extra little tips of the strawberries go to our tortoises, so we don't waste nothing.
So this is my little one doing her laundry. At around 13 months, she would help me throw a few pieces into the washer. But now at 15 months, she's more advanced and she's able to do her load of laundry on her own. Now, a lot of people will look at this and say, well, why would you want a toddler to do their own laundry? That's being lazy. But actually, if you observe your toddler, you'll see that they want to be more involved in the things that you're doing. They actually find enjoyment in everyday activities. So this helps foster independence. And not only that, but it's a practical life skill that really helps with things like object permanence, their motor skills, etc. And like I said, my daughter really enjoys throwing the things into the washer. You'll see that she like bends her head in there to see like where it's going, and ultimately we both enjoy this activity.
Watch my one-year-old make a bell pepper sandwich for her dad. Wash your bell pepper. Cut your bell pepper. Add cream cheese, pepperoni.
Good job.
I follow you into the park.
Raspberries.
Gotta never love one like.
Et voila.
Yes. When your child hits you, you want to grab their hand gently but firmly and say, "I can't let you hit me. That hurts." Be loving. It's all in the tone of your voice. If you're being too firm and aggressive, they're going to think that you're lashing out at them. Hitting and laughing from children is so triggering, especially when you are trying to be gentle and kind. The reason toddlers laugh at you when they are in a sticky situation is because they don't know how to feel, they don't know what to do, and they suddenly feel shame.
Hey guys, so I got a package today from Lovery, and what came was the block set. It comes with many, many different blocks, and it also has another slot where there's even more colors. And now we're going to open the play set. And it comes with a large mat that they can play and roll in. It's very easy assembly, and it's perfect, perfect for this age and up.
A quick tidbit about language development. Children's right sides of their brains develop first, and the right side is the more playful, imaginative side, the feeling-based side, and that is fully developed around 3 to 4 years old. The left side of the brain develops later and lasts up until 7 years old. That's why the critical period for learning language is birth to 7 years old. If a child does not learn language within that time frame, there's a very limited chance that they will learn language later. And that's why it's very important for play, because this is how they learn, through play, when the right side of their brain, and they feel and they have so much emotions, and they're so not logical. And that's why they can't talk about their emotions, because the left side of their brain has not developed yet. So understanding that helps you understand your child and allow them more play experiences, and understanding that language develops after that.
Here's our Montessori bedtime routine. First, I lay out 2 options of clothing for my boys to pick from. Then I spray their clothes and their bed sheets with this Oilagic sleep spray. After that, I start the bath and the boys start getting all of their stuff ready. Here's Jonah carefully placing his diaper, and then he gets the lotion. Carter likes to get the hair detangler and brush. Carter didn't feel like picking out any toys today, so Jonah picked out the bath toys. After their bath, the boys got dressed. Carter does dress himself, but Jonah still needs a little help. Then I brushed Jonah's hair just to get out any knots, and then he brushed it and we clipped his nails. And then Carter got dressed, I put some detangler in his hair as well, and he brushed his own hair. And of course, I clipped his nails as well. Then the boys brushed their teeth. I accidentally deleted the video of Carter brushing his teeth, but they both brushed their teeth. And of course, I went over his teeth to make sure they were clean. And then we all read some books together. After that, Carter picked out a card for his Yoda and turned on his light, and he was ready for bed. And then Jonah went to bed shortly after.
Welcome to a new series titled Montessori Terms You Should Know with your favorite Montessori mom. Let's get into it. So the first term I want to talk about is sensitive period. This is a big one. So a sensitive period is a little period of time that Dr. Maria Montessori observed among children from birth to age 6. And they are a specific period of time in which a child is more sensitive to learning, whether it's a different type of learning or a particular skill. 5 to 6 sensitive periods, depending on the literature you read. The first one is the sensitive period for language, for order, for refinement of the senses, refinement of movement, and social relations. The 6th one, depending on the literature, is also for small details and tiny objects. I personally like to think of them as walking through a dark room. So you can still see things not very well, but you can still explore, you can hold things, touch things, learn about new things, but everything's dark, right? It's really difficult. And the sensitive period is when the light bulb turns on. So it's like, oh my gosh, wow, there are so many cool things in this room. It's so much easier to see. You can see things in greater detail. You're so much more interested. Lastly, some parents will worry, I was one of them, if you miss that window of the sensitive period. Oh my gosh, is your child behind? What's gonna happen? Will you ever be able to make that up? And that's not how they work. So